Flourishing fam, welcome back to my channel. Welcome to Flourish with Dolores, where flourishing is about progress and not perfection, honey. I'm Dolores, this is my husband Charles, and in today's video, we are talking the pros and cons of dating, or in my case, being married to a physician. Charles is an emergency room physician. He's in his first year as an attending.
Second year, girl.
Oh, shoot. He started his second year of attending. That started this July, because you started last July.
Yeah.
So it's a year and like 2-3 months that he's been a full attending. And attending is when you are done with all your training and working as like a full-fledged physician. So he was officially a doctor when he finished med school, but then had 4 years of training in emergency. So this episode, or this video, we are going to be talking about the pros and cons of being married to this man.
I got some.
Actually, if you're watching this, pause it and write a con or a pro that you're guessing and see if you hit them right. So I'm gonna start with the cons and then we'll end on a positive note. So a con would be lots of schooling. So I started dating Charles when he was a senior in our undergrad at Seton Hall, and I was a junior. So from that moment through to when he completed residency, that was like 7 years of our relationship. 4 years in med school, 4 years, actually 8 years, plus that one of your last year of undergrad.
Yeah.
So that was 8 years of our relationship. He was in school.
Yeah, she was shooting with me in the gym.
I was shooting with him in the gym. And actually, I'll talk about a couple of the ways that I've done that with shooting it with him in the gym. You know, let me get my credit. You'll spit out your drink. I shot with him in the gym by sending him care packages when he was in med school. I would send him like cute care packages with like snacks and like things that I knew he would love and would kind of lift his spirits. Because I will say, when you're in med school and all of your friends have gone on to do master's programs that are either shorter or right after undergrad, go right into work and they're making money, going on vacations, and then you're just in the library, yeah, it does get a little sad. So I feel bad. And then I would send him care packages. Something recent, which kind of going on with the long schooling, is they are in school forever, and even now to this day he's studying for it, the other leg of his board. So he is board certified. He finished his— so it's not official till you do both.
Yeah.
So he did his written exam, and now he's doing his oral. So now I'm still shooting. because when he's studying, I'll like pretend that I'm a patient and kind of like look at his book, even though I don't even know half the words.
That's okay.
I'll try to see if I can insert a clip.
Yeah.
But even though I don't know half the words, I'll like, you know, try to like help him through so he can like study and kind of have someone to work with. So there is definitely, especially if you're gonna be a great partner to this person, there is a lot of shooting in the gym in different ways, especially with sacrificing the, you know, being with someone who's in school for a really, really long time. And sometimes that may delay the time that you guys get to start your lives together, depending on what your partner's values are with when they want to start their life with you, if that's when they finish school or not. So everyone's different with that.
Yeah, no, it's, definitely. If you are dating someone that's a physician, definitely understand that it's not as glamorous as they make it seem like on, you know, TV shows, social media, things like that. Like, it is a lot of schooling. And, you know, even for myself, I'm probably somewhere in the middle in terms of how long it actually takes. But, like, there are other specialties where their residencies can last from, like, 5 to almost 7 years.
Yeah.
And then they do an additional, like, fellowship as well. So, you know, just understand that if you're going to be with someone like that, you know, I mean, although it's support on both sides, like, understand that you are also going to need to support them through many, many years of training.
Right, right. The next con, number two, is random hours. But I guess this also depends on what specialty the person is. Charles, as I said earlier, works in an emergency room, so he does a lot of shift work. So one day he may work like 7 to 3, then the next day he's working 3 to 11. And then the next day he's working 11 at night to 7 in the morning.
Or
so
9 to 5 or 10 to 6.
9 to 5.
Yeah.
All over the place. And for me, it makes it really difficult for me to have more normal sleep hours because, and everybody's different, but for me, it's hard for me to fall asleep when I know he's still at work or I'm waiting for him to come home. So that becomes a challenge. And then on top of that, with having various hours and not having a typical 9 to 5 schedule where you're always off weekends, they tend to miss a lot of events, and sometimes that does get a little sad because you either have to go by yourself or miss a certain event because your partner can't go. So that definitely is a challenge when it comes to dating or being married to a physician.
Yeah, no, it definitely depends upon the type of specialty. Like for, you know, some of the primary care ones, they may have, and especially if they have like their own like practice, like their hours are a little more predictable and slash like flexible. But you know, if you're with someone like, you know, an emergency physician or even like a surgical specialty as well, their hours really aren't always that predictable. Like for surgeons, like they may go to work at like 5-6 o'clock in the morning, and then, you know, depending on how late or whatever the surgeries go, like they might not come back till like late at night. So I think that they're you know, can be some challenges with that. But I will say the beauty of like emergency medicine is that like when I'm off, like I'm off. Like I don't have to worry about being like on call, you know, or anything like that.
But if you're an academic emergency medicine, and you're off, I'm still doing other things.
But it's from like home, so it's not it's not bad. But like and it's stuff that I enjoy. But yeah, like I don't have to worry about like, oh my god, like, you know, I might have to like go in like the middle of the night, you know, or something like that. So that's, you know, I think that's a rewarding part. And also I feel like, you know, within our specialty people, they respect your time, and you know, a lot of emergency physicians are very successful at balancing their time with their families. They have time to do the stuff that they enjoy. So I'm glad I'm in a specialty that allows me the opportunity to do that.
Yeah. The third con, which is really a new con that I never thought I would have, is the fear of your partner. And a lot of that came in, you know, through the whole panoramic, whatever you want to call it, because for the first time, I think we really, you know, a lot of times we would call healthcare workers heroes, but for the first time, I think ever, we really started to see them as such, because essentially, depending on the type of healthcare worker you are, you were literally having to put your life at risk to take care of others because of what was going on in the world. So I think for the first time ever, when he would go to work, I would have to be very fearful for him. And that was really hard, especially before the vaccine and all of that, you know, came about. So that would definitely be the third con.
Yeah, no, I mean, I agree. I never really thought about being in danger going to work. Which is funny when you think about all things even before, you know, all this stuff.
Yeah, there's always some illnesses and viruses.
Yeah, like, I mean, I've dealt with patients like with tuberculosis before. The flu season is certainly no joke either. Like, and then, you know, even dealing with like agitated patients that come to the ER with weapons and stuff. Like, I just never had really crossed my mind thinking about all that stuff. But like now, you know, the way the world is now, it's just a totally different game changer. Like, I feel like I think a lot more about like safety and like, you know, making sure myself and my colleagues and stuff stay safe as well. But yeah, you know, so far, you know, I've been blessed, you know, staying safe.
Prayed up.
Yes, yes. So please continue to keep myself and, you know, other colleagues and other frontline workers in prayer for sure.
Yes. All right. So now let's go into our three pros. The first one I would say, which is a huge blessing, is you're dating or marrying someone who has a stable income. And now I always say this with Charles, because we talk a lot about like my entrepreneurial desires versus like a 9-to-5, and nothing really is stable. You know, God forbid, you can always, you know, be laid off or whatever. And we saw a lot of that in 2020. But for the most part, when you hear of someone who's a healthcare worker, you know, for the most part, they're gonna have a great salary and a stable income, because there's always gonna be, unfortunately, people who need healthcare. So that is a great benefit. I will say that a lot of times people assume automatically that we're like loaded. Money,
woo!
Just dancing in money, but we got loans.
Yeah,
we got loans.
Sally Mae will humble you real quick.
Sally Mae will sit you down right on her lap and tell her, you ain't nobody yet. I think for us, especially, you know, being, you know, having loans and, you know, not getting, we got undergrad paid for, we had full tuition scholarships, but for the most part, we still owe money. And so that takes a while to really build wealth and equity. So for me, the way I think, and you'll see that in the next video, is I'm always thinking about other ways to build wealth. So yes, it's a great pro, we're so blessed, he has a great income, stable salary, but it really does take a while for you to be married to medicine, as we see on TV. Number two, I would say it is really great to be with someone who has such a heroic job. And you know, my background's in social work. I'm in education. I would say we're heroes too. Shout out to all the educators, social workers.
Yes.
You know, but healthcare workers are heroes. And I think I talked a little bit about that in the cons, but I think we really saw that it is admirable to be with someone and to be proud to say, you know, my husband is a physician, emergency room physician, and saving a lot of people who you may even be related to or maybe one of your loved ones. So definitely appreciate you for that, baby.
Thank you. Appreciate it. I would just reiterate that, you know, it's definitely a team effort. Mm-hmm. I feel like that's one thing that sometimes people miss about like healthcare is like there are so many different people that are involved and you know what it takes to like actually like take care of like a patient. Like mm-hmm. it's not just the doctors and it's not just the nurses, it's the techs, it's mm-hmm. the clerks, it's yeah. the custodial staff, the respiratory therapists. Like it's really, really like a team effort, and like we wouldn't be able to do anything that we do on a regular basis without mm-hmm. all of us putting in the work.
Yeah, and also too, even beyond the hospital or the clinic, wherever, it's also the people at home. So like shout out to your parents for supporting you through mm-hmm. schooling and making sure that you got to where you needed to be, because that is something that also helps you become that healthcare hero. Definitely. And then, you know, I'm gonna toot my own horn too.
Shout out to partners
at home who are making sure, you know, depending on how you split your household chores, but making sure that there's food and that there's things that keep them happy in the home. And then also shout out to therapists, you know, especially during 2020, where a lot of healthcare workers, if they weren't before, I'm sure they are now, going to therapy. So those are all important people who kind of help healthcare continue to be successful. The third and final pro that I'm going to share for today's video is I get a built-in physician. I will say it took me a while to trust Charles. His healthcare tips, but he really is smart, very educated, and it's nice to have like a front line of like, you know, I will Google some things and just think I have all these different diseases because I got a headache, and it's nice for him to really balance me out and just really, you know, kind of give me that front view of maybe what it may possibly be. But one thing about Charles is he's like, you may want to talk to your doctor about that. Like, he will remind me he is not my doctor. But it is really nice, especially with women, all the different things that goes on in our body. I think for the average person who talks to their partner about it, they may be weirded out or freaked out. But for him, he's like, if I'm kind of freaked out to share it with him, he's like, you know, I'm a physician, right? Like,
yeah,
you can tell me this. It's not, I've seen it all.
Yeah.
So that is definitely like a great bonus.
This is funny when you talk about shooting in the gym. Remember when I was trying to learn how to do a physical exam?
And
I was like, hey, I got this new stethoscope that they gave me.
That day I was not shooting.
Can I practice listening to your heart?
I was like,
No,
you wanted to bang my leg with the knee thing. I didn't want you to do that.
No. Okay, yes. But
he came with a hammer, like, can I practice? I'm like, ew, no.
But I also wanted you to listen to the heart. You were like, oh, no to that. I'm like, I can't hurt you with it.
I was just scared. I was just being scared. Because literally, this was like his first year of medical school. And I'm like, I don't know what you learned yet. I don't know.
Everybody else is practicing. That's all I know.
Oh, just a random person? That
No, they're practicing with their partners.
I shoot in the gym now.
All right.
So that is it. That's it for this video. That's what it's like, the pros and cons of dating and then now being married to a physician. I definitely wouldn't have it any other way. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
We'll see what else is in store for our lives. So if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more videos like this, or you want to know more about us as a couple, we do a lot of videos about home, marriage, our lifestyle. So definitely make sure you subscribe. We are so close to being monetized on this platform. So please, please, please help us out and comment below what else you want to see from us. And we will see you in the next video. Peace.
See ya. And, oh, oh, sugar. Papa, thank you. Yeah.